So our cousin Bernard came from Texas. He came for his 60th birthday. Saturday was his birthday and Sunday was football Sunday. So he decided to make dinner for everybody. And he's a chef, like a real chef. Okay, certified. So I decided to record him at work because I was just fascinated in the culinary arts and I never knew how to make oxtails, so it's gonna be a good video. And the video is very informative. He explains everything as he goes. So stay tuned.
Vegetable stock for our rice and peas, right? Which we cook.
This is the seasoning for the oxtail.
That's the seasoning for the oxtail. That's
shrimp to season.
Season. And the plantains are seasoned as well. So
Sunday night football.
Getting ready for Sunday night football. That's it. The green beans is going to go with the onions.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And this is our trash bag. Always keep yourself a trash bag. And clean as you go. So we'll do the salmon last. And the rest of y'all, I'm gonna do that. But now I'm gonna season it and brown it and then have it ready, because the salmon is not gonna take long to cook. Make it a mix separate. And always remember, when we buy seasoning, don't buy seasoning salt. Don't buy seasoning salt.
You buy them everything separately and you mix it together.
Right, because when you buy seasoning salt, it has salt in it.
MSG.
MSG or whatever.
Yeah.
And it's going to make the food salty.
Right.
Yeah, so a little bit of that. And then we're gonna rub that on
the salmon.
On the salmon. Little herbs.
So that something like that is no good either.
This?
No, what you got in your hand.
This one?
Yeah.
As long as it's not, doesn't have salt in it. It's good if you're just using it by itself.
Mm-hmm.
But when you're doing, yeah, this one's got salt in it too. You can see the little salt crystals. Because if I use this one, that one, and that one, that one,
mm-hmm.
Oh,
too salty.
Too salty.
Let me see this.
That one's got a little bit.
Ooh, lemon pepper.
Mm-hmm. All right, and then.
That's 4% sodium in
here. Sodium, yeah. Something, yeah. The sodium helps to preserve the aromatics that's in there.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
That, and I want a little bit of oil, right? A little oil will rub on the fish. Right, we're doing all this, so it's all gonna get treated. The same way. Like that.
Like you need a bed in the kitchen.
Huh?
Kyrie, like you need a bed in the kitchen, everywhere you go.
He's smelling all those aromas.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so, this I'm gonna just sprinkle some on top. But I'm going to put a little bit of seasoning on the bottom of it. Okay?
Okay.
And that's what we move over here. This is boiled. Take this off. I want the juice from the oxtail. But that's my broth, so that's why I boiled it three times.
Okay.
Right, so you see the liquid? Mm-hmm. You see that liquid is kind of clear. It doesn't have all that mucky muck in there. You don't want the mucky muck. That's not good. So, and that's going to be my boiling liquid. The rest, I got it in there. Right? Mm. Cooling down.
Mm-hmm.
I'll put these on top and put them back in the refrigerator until I'm ready. Because I want them to be cool.
Back in the refrigerator?
Right. Yeah.
It's dry?
Sort of.
Oh, I just didn't want them to step putting their feet on it.
So
put it in my room.
Put it in
the put it in my room.
So I got the salmon there, right?
Okay.
Put a little bit of oil on there.
Oh, OMG. Who we at? Betty Hanna?
There you go. See? Bam.
Yes.
And that's going to give me my little color on the bottom.
Created a grill, y'all.
There you go.
Nice sear.
Nice sear on it, right?
Yeah.
You can slide the fish over a little bit, just so it don't stick. You just want to brown it a little bit.
I think the back is a little high.
Yeah, the back is a little high.
That's the front.
Yeah,
oh,
that's the front. Okay. Then also too, you got to be concerned is that this part of the fish is thicker than the tail end.
So the thinner end is going to cook faster.
It's going to cook faster, right. So that's why I'm also why I'm rotating it. Our little seasoning. Put a little bit of our seasoning on there. Right, and then she's ready.
Mm-hmm.
Bam.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a good sear.
Good sear. So she just to brown it. These are the oxtails, right?
Mm-hmm.
So these are the boiled, just boiled in water. I'm going to toss them in here, in the natural fat, right?
We'll give it that salt.
Yeah, the natural fat is going to give it just what we want. Okay? And we're seasoning it too, as well.
Right.
And this is lightly coating it. So when we brown them, that's the first thing your mother said when she came in. Yeah, yeah. And then wait a minute, who doing this? So everybody's got their own. But how we're going to cook it, we're going to braise it. It's going to be braised.
What does that mean?
Slowly cooking its own juice to braise. So you see, remember the liquid that I saved?
Yeah.
Right. Oh my gosh.
With it being drenched in the flour, the moisture of the meat is absorbing the flour.
Yeah.
Right?
Uh-huh.
So this pan here, is my browning pan. This pan here is where I'm gonna braise, right?
Mm-hmm.
With my liquid. This is my oxtail
broth.
Stock, right? Mm-hmm. The broth. And this is my browning mix that's gonna color. So you'll see all how it's gonna come together.
This so you mix all everything here.
I mix
the tomatoes, brown sugar, except barbecue. Okay.
I'm gonna put in that.
What's the brown? Right.
We want this hot. And then I don't want to overcrowd the pan. Right?
Mm-hmm.
I just want to get it in there.
Whoa, losing oxtails.
Flour will fall off of the meat, and it's not going to get where I want. So I want to cook out the flour as much as I can. Bam. And repeat the same process, right? Oil. We don't want to cover it because if you cover it, it's going to sweat. We don't want it to sweat. See how nice and brown that is in there?
Yep.
That's what we want. And that, this one, clove. Put a couple of cloves in here early. Cloves are very, very strong. And thyme, I'm putting in the seasoning in there already. For the initial. Thyme goes good with meat. Especially beef. Thyme and oregano. Braising is different than stewing.
Okay, so right now he's stewing.
No, right. Right now I'm just browning the meat.
Browning the meat.
Right, so we're gonna put this one in here.
To braise.
Here we're gonna braise.
Yes.
So you see how that's getting in there? Boy, we gonna have some hot action here in a minute. Get a little bit more oil. Okay. And now we're gonna go in. Right? So when we're braising, we want whatever we're braising, we want that liquid. Ooh, sorry. We wanna make sure that the liquid is all the way in the bottom. Alright? Mm-hmm. This is going to be later. We're pouring this in the middle, but we want it in the middle.
Okay.
That's all our liquids. Now to get the rest of this, we're going to see, I can get it in there by just stirring in the middle, see?
Right.
I can just stir the rest of the trying to stir it and stuff flying all over.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little cooking technique. Go right in the middle there, and it's gonna spread itself around. So you see how the liquid is brown, and it's going to brown the oxtails. But we want some of the Cajun seasoning, a little. Okay, you see the stuff on the top?
Yep.
That's the impurities. We don't want that here. So, put a little more oil on it. So what I'm going to do is skim this off. get it over here. I just want that. I don't want the liquid. I just want this. One or two cloves, right? Mm-hmm. Two parts of the rice. Peas to the rice. Right? And just stir it. Get it in cold.
Yes. Mm-hmm.